Were the dinosaurs wiped out by a huge asteroid's impact? Or was it a giant volcanic eruption? A fierce debate raged on. First imagined a supernova explosion by a star that has reached the end of its life. That's because if a star near Earth had exploded about 66 million years ago, it would have showered the Earth with iridium. But that would have also produced plutonium, which was not found, and so this theory was rejected. Louis then turned his attention to the countless asteroids orbiting in the belt between Jupiter and Mars. When the orbit of an asteroid, which could measure up to tens of kilometers in diameter, changes due to a collision in space, and it collides with Earth, it becomes a meteorite. If an asteroid smashed into Earth, it would bring with it massive amounts of iridium. Assuming that the KT boundary layers around the world contained iridium, Louis estimated the meteorite's size. This became the Alvarez hypothesis, which was introduced in 1980. It posits that an asteroid 10 kilometers in diameter struck the Earth, creating massive clouds of dust with its impact. This caused massive environmental changes that led to the dinosaurs' extinction. However, the road to acceptance of this theory was hardly a smooth one. There was one flaw in the asteroid impact theory. The crater that such an impact would have made had never been found. Such a crater was estimated to measure 200 kilometers in diameter. If it were on land, no one could miss it. By that time, about 100 craters had been found, but none matched the size and time period the scientists were looking for. So Hildebrand decided to take a fresh look at the world's KT boundaries from a new perspective. In March 1987, he traveled to the KT boundary in Texas. Here he saw some features seen in no other KT boundary.
So 66 million years ago, where we're standing would be in the middle of the continental shelf, and we would have about 100 meters of water on top of us. And on the shelf, we're depositing just this fine-grained gray mud. And we see millions of years of this mud. And then right here, something extraordinary has happened. Something has come and eroded the seafloor and ripped up the sediment in 100 meters of water. So this had to be a giant wave. And this deposit is different. We had the initial giant wave or waves, eroded the seafloor, moved material, started dumping it. Then the smaller waves coming, moving the sediment, of course still very fast for this environment.
The KT boundary that was assumed to be 1 centimeter thick grew to 1 meter with the sediment from the wave. Perhaps this giant wave was produced by an asteroid impact. Hildebrand took this theory and went looking for the point of collision. He went from Texas to the Caribbean island of Haiti to narrow down the site candidates. His findings pointed to the Gulf of Mexico and the Caribbean Sea just south of the US. Researchers examining the rock under the Yucatan had found shocked quartz. These intersecting parallel black lines indicate that it had been subjected to a strong impact. This was the best evidence yet of the giant collision. In 1991, it became clear that the circular pattern Penfield had found was formed by an asteroid's impact. The region at its center had become a fishing village. The crater that altered the course of Earth's history was named after this village, Chicxulub.
I'll never be an astronaut and walk on the moon, but when I'm walking here, I picture I can mentally reconstruct it and I'm walking across Copernicus or something on the moon with a little bit of earthly cover on it, some vegetation, a little bit of limestone, but it's right there under our feet.
A giant 180 kilometer crater that was formed 66 million years ago. This was the evidence that asteroid theory scientists were waiting for. Its size and age were just as they had predicted. 10 years after the discovery of iridium in the KT boundary, the final piece in the puzzle of the dinosaur extinction mystery had been found. This led to the acceptance of the asteroid impact theory.